My name is Andy Tannenbaum, and I'm a professor at Foo University in Amsterdam. And my research is about making operating systems more dependable and more reliable than they are now. In 1987, I launched Minix One. Minix stands for Mini Unix. The idea of Minix One was to make a system for education to teach students. But we've been evolving, it's been evolving since then. In about 2004, we've got as far as Minix Three. And the goal of that system is to make a highly reliable, highly dependable operating system. Minix 3 is very small. The core part of the system, which runs in kernel mode, is only about 10,000 lines of code. If you compare this to Linux, which is about 5 million lines of code, or Windows 7, which is probably 10 to 20 million lines of code, you can see how small it is. If the operating system on your desktop or notebook computer crashes, you may lose half an hour's worth of work, but you can reboot and it's no big deal. Now think about the operating system that controls an airplane or a nuclear reactor or medical equipment in a hospital. If that crashes, people could die. So we need to move to a world where computer systems are 100% reliable. Another area we're targeting is live update. Now, operating systems are constantly changing, there are new versions, fixing bugs, and so on. Most of the time, in current systems, you have to reboot the computer to put up a new version of the operating system. What we're trying to do is make it possible to update the operating system to a new version while it's running. Banks, e-commerce sites, industrial process control, and so on need the ability to run 24/7. The Minix 3 architecture puts most of the operating system running as user processes. So for example, if a device driver, like a disk driver or some other driver crashes, it's possible to recover it while the system is running. So we think this modular structure makes it possible to have a very reliable system and also do live updates.